Good morning all. Today we will see the third unit. So in this unit we will cover what is the cloud, what are the service models of that cloud, and what are the design architectures we are using for computing and storage of the these clouds, like data centers, what we are using. If any disaster has been occurred, how we are going to recover, and some public cloud platforms are there. So Google App Engine, Amazon Web Service, and Microsoft Azure. We will look these examples and we will see the structures of these clouds, and we will study what they will perform, means also the differences will be covered also. And apart from these, the resources has been shared through this cloud. So how these resources are managed, and sometimes we are allowing the resources to be shared between the clouds. So that also be included in this one. So whenever we are dealing with a network initiated one or any a computing oriented one, we will think of security and the trust management. What are the techniques it is using for detecting intrusions, and what are the protection techniques it is having, what are the defense strategies it is applying whenever means an intruder has been raised and has been means entered into our environment or trying to enter into our environment, like this. These things will be covered in this unit. Today we will see the first topic, that is cloud computing and service models. So here we will cover what is a cloud, and then what are the types of the clouds you are having, and what are the differences between the centralized and distributed clouds, and then what are the networking, what is the networking structure we are using when you are dealing with the data center networking. And also the second topic, which is what is the ecosystem of a cloud, and what are the technologies we are using. What means what could be the main objectives of the cloud, and later we will see the services which has been provided by the cloud, that is infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. So these are the things we'll be covering in this session. So first, why we need the cloud computing, means the first ever class when we started this cloud computing subject, I described what is the need of the cloud computing, how we can specify who initiated this cloud computing. So if you remember John McCarthy in 1966, that time what they have done is what he has proposed an idea is, there should be a chance of utility computing, means it's not been named as a cloud computing there. So first itself, it is used as a utility computing. Why we are using this utility computing, or why we need to support this utility computing, means whenever we are dealing with a normal life, when you need a object, or when you are when you need a thing and you not able to purchase that thing, what you are doing is you are going to somewhere where it is available, and you are getting this thing to be available for only particular amount of the time. And what you are doing, you are paying amount for that thing. So here we can specify, you can take any example here. You can take electronic devices as an example, or simply you can take what are the things we are using for organizing a function or anything, whatever you are specifying, what it is doing is, whatever you are using will be not be available with you, means the concept is you can go and purchase and you have to own that one, is not the permanent one. What it is say, what the world or the what you, in the normal life what you are doing, we are making the things available with you by paying for them. So by that idea, what it is doing, what the John McCarthy supported other has is, why can't we use the utilities of the computing to be available with organizations or the users or a group of users by paying and having the services or the having the benefits of that one. Like that, we need to, like that, they specified, means he gave a idea about that thing. So after later all the developments has been made, and then next, what they done here is after many years, not only 2 years or the 3 years, after many years, what did happen here is the cloud computing came into existence, and they didn't named it as the cloud computing, because what it is specifying here is, if you need to use a cloud computing or anything, you need to take the several things into an account. Means if you want to take any representations like a cloud, there could be a presence of the internet. So internet is not there when this idea has been proposed by the McCarthy. So first the internet was introduced in 1969. Later what they done here is, now they came to know that these computer, their utilities can be, means the electronic utilities or the telephonic utilities or any individual utilities has to be available with the human beings who are situated at their individual homes or offices or any environment you can specify. So by the time what they are doing is, they are just working on all these things. If you see where after 2000, means after many years, the cloud computing came into existence. And the cloud, why they given this cloud here is, they simply given the, because we are connecting many systems or the many servers, or you can specify many components into a network, and which is not having a network shape, or that means it is not having any structure. So it is simply a lookalike cloud. That's why they named it as a cloud. And by using this cloud benefits, we are computing. That's why we are taking these cloud computing into an existence. So this is the brief of our cloud. So the cloud computing, what the cloud computing doing here is, it is benefiting the industry because it is making some advances in our computing, which is the business oriented one you can specify, or you can go for the organization oriented one. The organization can be a college, or it can be any organization you can be specified, and it is giving a chance to take the benefits of that one, and it is providing the services to that one, and it is having a paradigm of high throughput computing. What is the HTC and what it is HPC means? HPC means performance computing. Throughput computing means HTC. Performance means, likewise as I said, it will be look after for a task only. If we are executing a task, what could be the performance will be specified here is, it is the performance will be taken for that particular amount of time only. The task is executing. If you specify the task is executing for that 10 minutes, the performance will be taken for that 10 minutes only. If you go for the throughput, what it is specifying here is, it will go for the long intervals of the time, or you can take the some decades also, or some centuries also you can specify. So you are taking a technology into an account, and you are specifying the throughput. So what is the throughput means? For how many years it has been existing, and how it is going to performing, or how it has been performed, and what are the advancements taken into an account, all these things, if any fault has been occurred, how these components or how these systems has been executed successfully, all these things has to be taken into account when you are dealing with a cloud computing. If you are having a any servers or anything, so we need to think whether this server is using for a long time or not, and these servers are providing the services regularly or the frequently or not, without any fail. Like that, we need to specify or we need to consider. So that's why the computing, the cloud computing, what you are doing here is, it is completely supporting the paradigm, that is the
throughput, and it is not for a single task or a particular amount of the time what you are performing fastly, and you are not giving the relevant, or you are not providing anything like that. It is not specified here. So here in this one, first we will see what are the types of the, that is the deployment models you can say, and what are the clouds we are having. We are having three types of the clouds. First one is the public, and then private, and then hybrid clouds. So before going to this one, first we will see what is the centralized computing and the distributed computing. Centralized computing means the server will have the control on the all the systems what they are having. Means it the individuals won't have any if you specify control or anything of their own, means individual responsibilities are not there with them. So that is the centralized one. So one thing will be controlling all these things. What is the distributed computing here is the nodes what you are using, means the systems what you are have using in computing here or in a cloud environment, all they are having equal responsibilities and equal privileges and also control. All these things will be coming to account when you are dealing with the distributed computing. So here, what type of the computing will be supported by the cloud? So the first thing, what type of means, whether it is a decentralized one or a distributed one, we need to specify. So here, the cloud what you are using will be the centralized computing at the data centers. Likewise, some people will say, and the other people will say here is, when you are dealing with the data center resources, it will be handled or it will be enacted as a distributed parallel computing. So here the views of providing the what type of computing the cloud computing will support here is the opposite views. Why? Because here it could be centralized one or it could be a distributed one, and it is not, and if it is supporting both the environments, means it is literally what you will say here is the controlling mechanisms or what you are doing here is will be off hands, because we can't take control or we can't do anything when you are dealing with the both the environments at a time. So all these things are being like the myths. So the fact what you are having is the computations what you are using in the cloud computations or the cloud applications will be distributed to the servers in a data center. Means here the applications what you are using are in a distributed environment. All are having their own controls, and then next to own memory spaces or own responsibilities to be handled. And the main things what you are want to be handled will be done by the providers or some in yesterday's class we have seen some general managers are there, that is group managers are there, and then next cloud managers are there. Likewise, what you are doing, all this, a group of people will be enacted to take care of all these things into the cloud environment here. So here, while we are dealing with these things, so we need to take this, the cloud platforms what you are using are distributed here, and they are being virtualized by this thing. Means virtualization means we are making the available the resources what are not with you to be available and to be used by you by using virtualization concept. So before going to that one, what are the cloud providers or the who are providing these clouds? First one is Amazon, next to Google. Amazon is providing EC2, Amazon AWS. You have well heard about the AWS. And Google is providing the Google App Engine. Microsoft is providing Microsoft Azure in different platforms. They are not supporting all the services there. Amazon, Google, and then next Microsoft are not being designed for supporting the services of your cloud, which is the infrastructure platform, and then next software at once. All these are concentrating on their own zones, and they are creating the environments to be available with us to get the benefits of that one. So this is about the computing environment we are using in the cloud computing. Before going to that one, I need to memorize you. There is a word called the SLA, Service Level Agreements. So the service level, if you forgot that thing, I am memorizing you. SLA has been chosen. So who are the service providers or the cloud providers? Amazon, Google, Microsoft, or many are there. These are the popular one. And what they are doing is they are giving the services to be available for us. So here we need to avail the service. For availing the services, what you have to do is nothing but we need to make an agreement between the providers and between us. So we need to place an agreement. That agreement is specified as a SLA, Service Level Agreements. So what the service level agreements will include here is, whenever you are facing a problem, how come they are overcoming with that problem, and what are the services they are providing, how extent they are providing, what are the privileges given to you, and what is the period of services to be, means the time span will be mentioned there, and then many things, what are the security mechanisms they are taking, if any problem has been occurred, how they are taking care, all these things has to be done in this SLA. So if it is not done before, we may not have a chance to question, or we may not have the chance to get the things to be done in a smooth way. So that's why what we need here, we need an agreement between the providers and the end users there. So that's why SLAs will came into account, and which plays a major role while dealing with the cloud platforms or the cloud providers you are having. So here, if you see, this is the diagrammatical representation which is showing what is a cloud and how many clouds are there, and what are the deployments you are using, and what are the providers there also you are having here: Microsoft Azure, Amazon, AWS, IBM's BlueCloud, and then next Google's AppEngine, Salesforce, Force.com. So these are the five cloud platforms we are having, are the five cloud providers. And what providers, what they are providing is their names are Azure, AWS, BlueCloud, AppEngine, Force.com. So here, some are represented on behalf of this thing is right side, and if you see, there is a left side, private cloud is there. IBM is providing a public cloud, and IBM is also providing a private cloud, which is specified as the IBM RC2. If you see that one, IBM RC2 is a private cloud. So here, how we are going to access the private cloud means if you want to IBM RC2 want to access any services of a cloud situated here, means Microsoft Azure, that is Amazon Web Services, and then any BlueCloud or anything. So if he want to access the services of any five among that one, there is no chance of connecting to this environment directly. Although this is an internet, this is the public internet, but it is not having the chance to to interact with any cloud which is having the access to the public internet. So that's why what it has to do here is we need to create a public network. Through this public network or through this public cloud, this private cloud will be able to access any service or any data of these clouds connected to this internet. So the combination of private clouds and then public clouds making available at a time is a hybrid cloud. So if you are having that one into an account, then it is specified as a hybrid cloud. What is a public cloud here is the public cloud is completely built over the internet only, because any people may means any user has the ability to access the internet through their phones or through their devices from anywhere. By if they are having a good internet connection, what it they are doing, they will access these things by any device or at any place. And how they are going to access here is they need to pay for this service. And there, that is the model what you are using here is the pay as you go model. When you are want to need the services to be available with you, we need to pay for the service and we need to get the subscription, and you will be able to access that one. So what are the clouds you are having in this public environment? Or GAE, AWS, Azure, all these things will be coming to an account. So what will be the advantage of this thing is any user can be access this one from the remote interface, and they also have the privilege of creating and managing their virtual machine instances with their infrastructure, with their own infrastructure. And it means surely it will deliver all these process, all these services without any fail. When you when you come with these private cloud, it is has to be built with domain only, one particular domain only for one organization, for one group of people, or for one environment only it will be chosen. And it has a ability to access in between these, means the private cloud also have the many users there. How these private cloud users will access the means services of these RC2 means they will use the intranet into an account, and they will come into that account usage of all these things. The clients and then next who are connected will be static only, because when you are dealing with the RC2, you will have the list of the users with you only. There is no increase in the that one, or there is no any decrease in that, because no one is leaving the organization, or no one are adding into the organization easily. So that's why what they are doing, they are maintaining a list of the people who are using the private cloud. So by usage of this private cloud, what is the advantage here is they will have how many users will use my services. Means if anybody wants the data center to be used by these RC2, what there is, how many people will have the access to the data center? For example, if we say group of 30 people will have the access, means only the 30 people will have only the accessibility for the data center. There is no need to maintain more than that that count, because there is no change in these things. Means easily we won't change the list of the users or the privileges of the users as our wish. So we are giving all these things to the that cloud. Means how many users will access this resource. So for example, some printers or the file access is there. So totally 200 people will access this one, means they will make available for the 200 people. And then next, if they will have only access for the 100 people, means they will be able to access for the 100 people only. But here coming to the public cloud, we can't say that how many users will access the resources. We can't imagine, because many lakhs of people will go for the services to be available with us. So we can't say this number of users will be will access this resource at particular amount of the time, or for this span of time like this, we can't say. So their problem arises. The resources will be, scarcity will be occurred. So here we need to take the that the resources were to be available, and sometimes the users who are requesting for these resources will be some waiting state. All these things will come into an account. But dealing with the private cloud is an easy thing, because you know what is the strength of the, or the what is the count of your staff, and who are accessing the resources, and how far they will access the resources. All these things will be with you statically. There is static information is there. There is no need of the dynamic allocations. There is no need of the dynamic resources to be added with you. All these things are not needed when you are dealing with the private cloud. And when you are having this information to be enacting or the to be used by other, or you want to get connected with the other one. So what the problem is, there is no direct pathway to get into this environment. What we have to do, we need to create a public cloud, and this public cloud will take care of these processing which has been done with this private cloud and this public cloud environment. And these both indeed are specified as a hybrid cloud. And what are the environments we are using here is this one. So coming to this environment, a typical public cloud. What is the public cloud is represented as? It is having the service queues and a platform front end, that is a web service API, application interface, what you are using. And also it maintains a data center. In this data center, we have the server clusters and also the cloud storage here. So on all these things, we are using that is what you are performing. So the service queues means, likewise I said, we are requesting for the service. If you are requesting for the service, what the cloud operator or the provider will do is, the provider will look after what the service you has been requested, and you have the privilege of access of that service or not. You have the subscription of that service or not. First, it will look after that thing, and then it will allow you take the access of that resource. Means if you want to access any data center, if you want to access any server, or if you want to access any deployment, any runtime environment, all these things will come into an account when you are dealing with a cloud. So if the services are not, if the resources are not available, means they are being, eventually used or the frequently used or busy with someone, what it has to do is nothing but we need to wait for some time. Later on, what they will do is they will allocate the resources, new resources to us, or make the things to be available. How these things to be available means, not only they are providing the things to subscriptions to us, it is keeping track of that one. How it is giving the track here is, it will look after whether the subscriptions done by me has been used successfully or not. Means I am subscribing to a service and I am availing that service also, but I am not using it. Availing the service is different and using the service is the different. Availing means I want to use a printer. What I will do? I will go for the printer and will sit there. Simply I am, what I am doing, simply I am browsing, or simply I am taking documentation to be done like that. So, and remaining people are waiting there. So for that particular amount of time, what I am doing, I am not using because my data is not ready with me. So to perform that task, meanwhile, what I have to do, I have to take these resources to be available for someone. So that is the thing. Because when you are dealing with an electronic device or anything, they should be not idle, because what they are being designed has to be done by them. So what they have to do, they have to be available with the other person. So how come I came to know that I am free means, that is, I know I am free. So how come they came to know all these things means, they need to keep track of all the services, whether these services have been availed by them or has been used that is subsequently or not. All these things has to be considered into an account. If you are not considering, means what they are doing, simply we are accessing a resource and we are keeping with us and we are doing nothing with us. Because we are not doing means we are not wasting that one. At this present time, I don't have the information. I don't have the any data to be deal with that resource. So what I have to do, the whenever I am having the that is zeal of using, means using is there, availing, not availing, zeal of using is there, then only I have to request for that thing. I'm simply going and having the availing that one, and you are not using and keeping with me for the idle for entire time. What it is doing here is, it is the wastage of my time and wastage of my money and others also. So that's the thing. So that's why what I have to do is nothing but they will look after the keen things has to be done, has to be maintained by the anyone what you are providing here. So this is about your public roads. Likewise, I said it is built over the internet what you are using and what the services they are provided, how you are going to access, means who has paid for the service has the ability to access these public cloud, and who is paying means any user can pay the for that service and they can access the public cloud over the internet. So here are the examples: ZAE, AWS, Microsoft Azure are the public clouds, are the public clouds what they are providing. And coming to the private means there should be with the domain only, means they are not out of an organization. If you want to access that private cloud, you should be a member of that organization, that's all. And if any means if you want to interconnect with the any other public one, what you have to do is nothing but we need to take the help of the public cloud, and then next we need to establish a connection, then we are able to connect to the public environment whenever we are needed, not only all the time. So the last one is the hybrid cloud. Hybrid cloud means if a cloud is built with the both public and private cloud, then that environment is called as a hybrid environment. So here how they are doing here is when you are not able to access the public environment, the private cloud will use the public cloud and then provide the access to be done to that one. That environment is said to be the hybrid cloud environment. So that's about the deployment models what you are having. And coming to the data center networking structure. So here the cloud what you are using is specified as a server cluster. There you have seen in the diagram there itself, the data center what you are using for the cloud is represented as a virtual machines, which is specified as a server clusters there itself. And it is also have the usage of the several computer nodes under it, and also try to control it, that is managing the resources to them, scheduling their work and what are the activities to be done by them, what you have to use these things, means what are the resources to be required, what are the data elements to be required, all these things will has to be look after the by these cloud here. So for this we need a structure. So the structure is a data center networking structure, which is for the cloud to access the internet here. So here there are many latches or the many things are there. So here we are having multiple layers. In this multiple layers, the we are first underneath layer is there. So the underneath layer is having some is, if you see this one, this block is specifying what are A's, what are S, LB, AR, and then XPR. A stands for the rack of the servers what you are using, means the servers what you are representing will be there, and it is maintaining a switch for the rack of the servers, means it is having means when you want to connect to the servers, the servers are grouped to one thing, and then next they are maintained under a switch there. So here the S1 is the L2 switch. So here L2 switch, here is the layer 2. So here what it is doing is it is maintaining many servers here. These many servers are being under with the there is rack of servers are under with the two switches. If anyone has been failed, the other one will look after all these things, if you see there. So not only they are, you can specify them 10 or hundreds of the servers will be there under this switch, and also it is having a load balancer has to be maintained here. And at last to go for that layer 3, which is the data center, it is having AAS means access routers has been specified, and also we are having another one is the BR, that is a border routers. BR stands for the border routers, which are under L3, that is layer 3. And at last we are having internet. What is the layer 1 is the infrastructure what you are using for connecting that one. So this structure what you are using here is the supercomputers has been used this thing to be done. So this network what you are choosing or what you are represented has a fat tree representation or 3D notorious networks what you are using. Means 3D networks or fat trees or the names which has given for these representation on your screen. So what it will do? So first what we have to do is nothing but what are the internet's facilities or the what is the internet we are using here is it is using IP internet or the IP commodity networks, which are the Ethernet networks which is supporting 10 Gbps, and also it is having some optimized access to providing all these things. This multi-layer structure what you are means having here is well able to make the systems or the make the things to be have the accessing the internet. Means it is making the accessing of the internet to be processed or to be done here. So if you are dealing with a private cloud or anything, what it has to do, it has to look after all these things. So it has to connect to the different environments and need to provide cloud to take care of all these things. If you want to take access of the things, first we need to take these servers, rack servers into an account. These rack services are under the maintenance of the switches here. The switches what you are using are the fast switches. So here how they are using is when you are connected, when you are having the ability to access the rack of the service, they need to connect to these server racks, means sorry, these fast switches, and also to the hardware core also. So they are connected to these rack servers easily because the switch is able to allow these things to be connected fastly. And the data center what you are using is connected to the internet as means with the layer 3. Where before going to these connected, we need to take what are the accessing routers. Means who are the permissions to access like this, we need to specify. Because the access routers having only permission to the one switch, they is not able to specify. Means the access routers what we are maintaining will have to able to access to the multiple switches here. That's why it is maintaining two. So any route can be specified. So if you have gone through this route, you will be able to access any switch here. So that's why we need to connect all these things into any. So and also we need to take these things to be done here also. So here the server switches what you are using have been connected to everyone, everything here. And so on is represented, everything will be connected to this switch, everything will be connected to this switch. Why? Because if any failure has been occurred, it has to be looked after by these things what you are having. So if a failure has been occurred with this switch, means this switch will be took care of these things what you are having. But also you are having access routes, it's not the possible of accessing this one, then multiples will be taken into an account, and by using this thing, it will have the racks of the servers here. The racks of the servers what you are using here is a specified as a single layer only. But what you are doing, if anything has been failed, then you need to able to access or you need to process your data. So how come it will be done? Means if any failure has been occurred, that other things should be available to be processed with one. So this one has been failed, so this one will have the same amount of the data, same data process. And it will allow to be executed here only. So that's about the networking structure what you are having, and the development trends there. So yeah, as of we know, we are having many representations when you are dealing with the public, private, and the hybrid cloud. So how we are going to handle all these things? So if you are dealing with the public clouds, they have the future of accessing by the many public, but all the things has been done by the public network only, that is the internet. There we need to maintain a high security. So that's why we need to take the concentrate on these high security matters when you are dealing with the development trends of the public cloud. If you say private clouds, So the private clouds are for organization only. Means if there is nobody will enter into that one, only that people will access that one, that data, and what you are doing will be secured there itself only. And if you want to need to access that type of data only will be able to connect to the public cloud, and it allows to be happen, or the means the means what you are using between these things, that is public and the private clouds will be happen. So if you are taking private clouds here into consideration, because public clouds has the no means security is very low when you compare with the private clouds. That's why the private cloud environment is going faster when we are comparing these both, that is public clouds and then private clouds. But here the thing is the cost effectiveness. The cost effectiveness is important one. So if you want to maintain it's your own cloud, here what it has to do here is there will be no other person will take care of all these things. You should be available to take care the things when any problem occurs, because you are only the cloud provider. When you are dealing with the public cloud, there are many providers there. So the if any problem occurs, that will be dealt by the that will be take care by the their providers. That could be not burden on the organization. So to take care of these clouds, infrastructures, and then the service, that is the quality of the service, what they are providing in private clouds, we need to maintain a person or that group of the people to continuously work on that cloud environment. If any problem arises there, someone should be able to look after that one and take care that thing and give the results, best results, and means any fault has been occurred, you need to already any component has been failed, what you are doing, you need to take into an assist that is account, and you need to process all these things here. So that's why we need to develop these things into a manner that in future use there could be no loss of data or anything, any type of the things if you consider. And the next one is the cloud ecosystem and enabling technologies. So here, if you see classical computing and cloud computing, so how we are going to specify and what are the things we need to do here is, first we need to take what is the classical computing and what is the cloud computing, and we need to take care means how we are going to do here is, we are taking a project and we are going to handle this project in two environments, and we are taking the computing paradigms into an account, and we are differing them with these two environments here, and also we are taking cost models which has been applied to that one. So here when you are dealing with this one classical computing, we need to do the work, means whenever you are dealing with a project, first we need to take some initiate steps. That initiate step, that process what you are doing has to be repeated itself, or we can say itself, every 18 months. Means every 18 months means after 1.5 years, what you have to do, you need to take care of the things what you have installed. After that, if you go for the cloud computing, there is no need to be done by you. So who will look after they? So you have to subscribe that thing. For subscribing, what you are doing, you need to pay as you go for each service provided. Means there is no need to take care of that services or that any softwares or anything what you have been installed. So then there is no need to be take care of by me. Means who will take care of that thing? Means the provider will take care of that any software, any runtime environment, all these things when you are concerned. So next one is, if you want to use any hardware or system software or applications to be need, that is any tools or extra support you things, all the any library files, all these things you want to use in classical computing, then what you have to do, you have to go for the shop, or you have to go for any website, you have to order for them, and you need to buy them. and you then you it will become that it's my bone. Then only you are able to use in classical computing. And what you are doing here, I want to use an hardware. I want to use any software applications or tools or any environment. What I have to do here, what means I need to simply subscribe. Means I need to go for the provider's page. I need to pay for the amount, and then I will get the service there. So if you want to get all the services to be available, then I will look after the what are the subscription I will use here to take the benefits of all these things. Then I will choose that thing. I will subscribe for that one, and then next. So purchase it some hardware or software or anything. I want to use that thing. So how are we going to use in classical computing means I want to install it. Next, configuration has to be done. I need to test, verify, evaluate, and then next use. After that, I have to manage all these things. So this has to be done by you. Frequently, you are not doing installation, configuration, testing, verification, evaluation, management, and then all these things will be done by you eventually. And when coming to the cloud computing, there is no need to installations or anything. What they are doing, they are simply going to use that thing. So here, not everything will be means included. Only the last thing what you have been, for what you have been purchased this system software to use. So that's why we are simply, what are you specifying here? I am using it. I'm not performing any task before use. I'm simply going to use that thing. After that, what I am doing means after many things I am using here. Next one is the cost. How I am paying that one? Because here I want to pay to the high cost. Why? Because I want to pay the high cost means for what I am to using the software means to develop my projects or to keep my data, anything. So when you are dealing with that one, the cost will be high. Means when you want to purchase the multiple softwares, you need to purchase these softwares and you have to pay thousands of money to be on that one, to the softwares there. So that's why the cost factor here is the high cost. When you go for this one, what you are doing is, when you are comparing with this thing, it's very low. Because you need to think what are the services you need. So here what the decides is, here the third term is called the quality of the services. Seema, when you are purchasing a service, all the services won't provide same means quality here. When you are paying more, then you will have the more quality. When you are paying low, then you have the less quality only. So that's why the quality of the service factor will decide what is the pay you are going to use. So you need to include all the qualities into your service. Then you need to pay little bit more here. But when you compared with this thing, it will be less only. So this this thing what you are using here is the is representing what is the thing we are specifying or what are the things we need to be done when compared with this cloud. Means why we are using cloud here means simple example. Simple go for these installations, all these things. There is no need to do all these things here. What I am doing is I am using the privilege of that thing. So you don't have the Microsoft Word, for example. You don't have the Microsoft Word. What you will do? You need to type some information, all these things. Because we need to go for the Google and search for that thing and installations are to be done. Or you need to take the some version which is the that is a genuine one. You will buy for that one. You will install all these things into that one. So the easiest way of using the that is a Word is go for your Gmail and take that what are the applications it is providing to you to be used. So in that you will find the docs. Docs will be there. So when you are clicking on the docs, it will open in a tab that is a document environment. Likewise, the Microsoft where that is a document only, and it is also Word document only, and it is also providing the services which has been given by this document only. And you don't have the Excel sheet. You don't have Excel sheet, and you are going to be store your data or use some estimations or anything. You don't have Excel sheet. No need to install the Excel sheet. What you are doing? Just go for that thing. Go for the Gmail, and then next go for the documents, and then next what you are doing? Sorry, go for the applications. You have to select sheets. Sheets will be there. Sheets, when you are clicking on the sheets, it will open the environment as you provided. And the next one is the runnable environment, runtime environment. You don't have a Python environment and you want to work with this Python. How you are going to do? You have to go for the installations. You need to install the Python, and you want to install any Anaconda. Is there any other supportive things? Are there all these things has to be installed by you? And finally, you are going to use that thing. So the easiest way is simply go for the Google and search for the Google Colab. When you are entered in that one, it is opening the environment, which is the Python. If you are well known about the Python, there are having many things to be done by you by importing this NumPy's, Pandas, directories or anything what you are using, and it is easily providing the environment to be available with you without paying anything. In this example, we are paying something, but these what are the three examples have been taken? There is no need to pay anything. So again, I'm taking simple example here. The fourth example is there is a Google Classroom is there. So Google Classroom, what I have to do there? I need to create a classroom for you. I need to send a classroom code. What will help you there? What will help you? So when you are needed, when you are entered into your classroom, so they will have some assignments. Assignments will be with you. And then next, any quizzes or their Google Forms will be there with you, have been created. So here, any estimations has to be done. Again, Google Forms will be there to be available with you. And then any assessment has to be done. All these things will be done at one place and you are be able to access. So here, likewise, we are creating WhatsApp group and passing the information here. And here in the classroom, what you are doing, you are creating a virtual classroom environment, and we doing some works which are being done by us. Means if I want to take a quiz, so I want to take a quiz, I'm not able to take a quiz here, and I don't want to waste my class, and what I have to do here is simply I need to create a quiz form. I need to post on that classroom. So here, what you have to do is nothing but you need to install the classroom. If you are using laptops or anything, any environment, there is no need to process all this. What you have to do is nothing but you need to install the classroom in your phone. So go to that class and then next you will be available to access that one. So the quiz has been sent to you. There is no need to send the link to all. So you have the access to your classroom. You will go into the classroom. And so these are the simple services we are having and we are not paying at all. And some services are free also. So that's storing your data or getting the access of these things, writing the blogs or anything, any type of the services to be available with you when you are dealing with this one. So these are the simple examples, simple cloud platforms, Gmail, what you are using also a cloud platform, it is providing other services which are the free for particular amount of the time. So what are the main objectives here? First one is computing, shifting this computing from desktop to the desktops, that is the data centers. What you are doing here is you are storing the data into your desktop. So that all could be stored on your desktop. You will move your data to your data centers here. So there is no need to maintain your local server or you need to maintain your main server, all these things. Not. So you are simply accessing the data from the data centers and giving the data to that centers only. So that's the first one objective. Why we need to design this cloud means we need to satisfy all these objectives here. First one has been the concentrating on the data centers. And coming to the second one, service provisioning and cloud economics. So provisioning means we need to available. We need to be available with the others. Means here the services what you have chosen be available here. We need to take care of all these users who are having availed these services. Means we need to have the resources to be available with us. So the resources will be provisioned. Provisioned means They are having a plenty of things. Whenever users has been requested for that one, they are simply giving one by one to them. Whenever users has been finished, they will return. They will have the accesses, means the resources what you are using will be freed there. So that's why what it is doing, it is maintaining the self-provisioning also, and also maintaining SLAs to be, as I already said, SLAs. So the provider means the cloud service what you are using will be described, or the will be provided a description in this SLA. And the next third one is the scalability. Scalability in performance means here the performance means the number of users will be increased, the number of users will decrease. So based on that one, the resources what you are using, the services, the infrastructures what you are using has to be added or has to be decreased based on the scalability of the users only, not by the only the that is infrastructures. If the infrastructure is having, if you are having only the 10 printers with you and you are allowing only 10 users, means it's a foolish thing. So what you have to do is nothing but many people are giving means accessing for that one. What you have to do, you need to make available with them also. And the next one is the data privacy protection. Here we need to take the whether what we have to do is, can I trust the thing? Is the data centers or trustable or not? I have to think. So here we need to take the trusted services into an account. These trusted services will make us the private data, or these the data, whatever the data we are using or that we are storing in the data centers will be handled, and there could be no loss of them, or there could be any intrusions will occur when they are keeping or when they are handling our data. And the next one is the high quality of the cloud services. So here the quality of the system, that the quality of the service will decide these thing. So the cloud, the quality of the services will be changed by user to provider, provider to user, provider to provider, cloud to cloud, like that. Means some things will be considered when you are deciding whether what are the services we are using. And then at last one is the new standards on the interfaces. How we are going to take into the account? So there is a lock-in problem is there. Lock-in problem means if you are aware of using, so many games are there, many applications are there, but we will stick on to use some one thing only. We won't use the others to be considered. Why? What is the reason here is, you may like that environment, you may like the services, you may like the handling the ways. If you have the problem, means you may have the interest in all these factors or in some of the aspects you are taking. Means lock-in problem means you will stick there only, and you are not easily move on to the new provider. Means I am with the Google App Engine, and also AWS is also providing same only, but I'm not able to move on to that one. What could be the reason here? So the reason will be you like the environment there, and you are being flexible with that one. Just you are frequent with that one, and you have to came to know the easiest use of that one. All these things will come into an account. If you take any game or anything, somebody will are using the PUBG is there, whatever, simply they are playing. Many disadvantages are there, many things have been happening. What they are doing is they are simply playing with that only. And they have, why they are playing means some interesting factor there. All friends are playing, they are discussing, and they are not, they are having fun with that thing. They don't have that environment in other apps or the other gaming apps. If somebody is creating that environment with that one also, we won't find that easiness in other environment. So if any application has been designed exactly like that also, but you won't feel easy, or you won't fit into that environment. So that is the lock-in problem. Stick on to one environment and you are not easily moving on to the other data centers or other cloud providers, that is considered. So here the cost model here is, means when you are dealing with the traditional computer, so what here is we need to take the capital amount, capital equipment. Ma, what is the capital equipment here is we need to make the installations now. So the for that installations we need to take that is the purchases has to be done. So this factor what you are using here is the cost which has been done for the installation of your equipments. And here is operational expenses here. So the operational what is the expenses here is means initially your system or the software will be working in a 100% a success way. So when you are dealing with that one, what is you are raising a problems. To fix that problems, we need to take the cost into an account. And the users what you are using, what you are providing here also using that one, and the eventually the cost factor has been reached the peak here. So users also increasing because all the users are not using the cloud services, because only the organization and one who have been able to access only they are presenting. When you are dealing with these that is a cloud computing cost model, so the number of users are increasing, but here there is no any capital equipment because there is no installations needed has been required here. So what we need to do here is we need to purchase just a laptop or a device, that's all. What you are doing here is you are taking a device here that to be available with us, and here also we are taking a device available with us, and we are adding some resources to that one. Here there is no need to add the resources to my environment. And the expenses has been increased when you compare with that one. It has been reached only less than half. It has been reached the half of the part. You know, also has been less than, and the number of users also increasing here. So that's about the cost model what you are having. In next class, I will describe the what is the cloud ecosystem we are using and what are the different service models we are using for that one. We will see the architectures of the AWS AppEngine who are providing the services also, because IaaS is provided by the Amazon, and then next PaaS, the platform as a service, is provided by these PaaS and then Azure, and also some Google Engine also. A software as a service means likewise I took some examples, that is Docs, Sheets, Google Colab, and then next if you take the PPT slides, all these things will be considered as the SaaS. There is a software as a service which has been developed earlier and you are using now. So that's about today's class, ma. Thank you.